Your DNA holds the blueprint for your whole body, right? But did you know that you can edit it without gene therapy? Most people think that genetics are set in stone, but here's the twist. Exercise can literally change the way your genes function, flipping the right ones on and the bad ones off. And the results? It changes the trajectory of aging itself. Hey, I'm Hitch. I'm 76 years old, but I function about 3 or 4 decades younger. Longevity science isn't just a hobby for me. It's my passion. It's what I do all day, every day. The way your body reads and responds to your DNA is controlled by something called the epigenome. And here's the good news. You can influence it. Research shows that exercise doesn't just strengthen muscles or improve endurance. It literally changes how your genes function, slowing down biological aging at the molecular level. In this video, I'm going to break down how exercise reprograms the epigenome, what that means for your health, and how you can use this information to take control of how well you age. Your DNA holds a blueprint for your entire body. For all intents and purposes, DNA is made up mostly of genes, which produce proteins. Depending on which genes are turned on or expressed and which ones are turned off. And this pattern of on and off can change with time and lifestyle. The real magic happens in the epigenome, the system that decides which genes get turned on and which stay off. Think of it like software that runs your genetic hardware, controlling everything from metabolism to aging. One of the key ways that it does this is through DNA methylation, a process that adds tiny chemical markers or tags to genes, flipping their switches on or off. When we're young, this system runs smoothly, but as we age, it starts to glitch. The wrong genes turn off. Others stay on when they shouldn't. This breakdown speeds up aging and increases disease risk. But here's the good news. This process is malleable. Research shows that exercise can reprogram the epigenome, restoring healthy patterns and slowing biological aging. It's not just about staying fit, it's about controlling how your body ages at the genetic level. Every time you exercise, every time you challenge your body, it modifies the way your DNA is read, flipping certain genes on and others off. Scientists have found that exercise reshapes DNA methylation patterns, activating genes associated with cellular repair and improved metabolism. At the same time, it dials down genes linked to inflammation and disease. In simple terms, it turns on the good stuff and silences the bad. One of the clearest ways we see this effect is through epigenetic clocks. These clocks measure your biological age, how fast your body is actually aging, based on DNA methylation patterns. Studies show that people who move more have younger biological ages. Their cells age more slowly. The Rhineland study found that active individuals had significantly lower epigenetic age acceleration. Another study in Japan confirmed the same thing. Exercise slows down the clock. And it doesn't stop there. Exercise also protects your telomeres, the little caps at the ends of your chromosomes that shorten as you age. When they shrink too much, your cells stop working properly. But regular exercise is linked to longer telomeres and higher telomerase activity, both markers of healthy cellular aging. That means better function, better recovery, and a longer health span. Look, exercise isn't just about looking good or staying fit. It's about reprogramming your body at the genetic level, slowing down aging from the inside out. How does that actually happen? What's going on at the molecular level that makes this possible? The Rhineland study looked at over 3,500 people and found that those who exercised more had slower biological aging. Scientists used advanced epigenetic clocks like GRIMAGE and DNA methylation PhenoAge to measure this. The results were clear. People who move more age slower. And this held true even when factoring in diet, smoking, and other lifestyle habits. A Japanese study backed this up. Researchers tracked nearly 900 participants and found that sedentary people had DNA methylation patterns linked to faster aging, while active individuals had methylation profiles that signaled a younger biological age. What made this study different? They didn't just rely on self-reported exercise. They used accelerometers, devices that measure actual movement, giving a more accurate picture of how activity influences the epigenome. Exercise also protects your telomeres. A 2021 study found that exercise activates telomerase, an enzyme that preserves telomere length. This effect is especially strong in endurance athletes and those who engage in high-intensity training, meaning that both moderate and vigorous exercise help protect your DNA over time. Your immune system also benefits. Studies on elite athletes, including Olympic champions, show that their epigenetic age is significantly lower than that of non-athletes. Their immune-related genes are methylated in ways that enhance natural killer cell activity and reduce inflammation. In other words, exercise doesn't just make you fitter, it keeps your immune system younger, more resilient, and better equipped to fight disease. By modifying DNA methylation, preserving telomeres, and enhancing immune function, exercise gives you a direct way to slow aging. And that means real-world benefits, better health, longer life, and more years spent feeling strong and capable. If longevity and preserving your health span is important to you, and you're looking for the latest interventions, protocols, and discoveries in longevity science, I've created a school.com community just for you. It's called the Longevity Alliance, and it's absolutely free. Inside, you'll find robust discussions, free lessons, and even the opportunity for group coaching. To join, just check out the link in the description. Aging isn't just something that happens to you. It's something that your biology responds to. When you move your body regularly, you're not just burning calories or building muscles. You're changing how your genes behave. You're reinforcing repair pathways. You're dialing down chronic inflammation. You're preserving metabolic function, muscle quality, and mitochondrial health. Over time, that adds up. You don't need extreme workouts. You don't need to train like an athlete. What matters is consistency, regular movement, enough challenge to send a signal, repeated often enough for your biology to respond. That's how aging shifts, from something that automatically accelerates as you age to something that you can actually have an influence on. Exercise doesn't stop aging, but it absolutely changes how fast it happens and how well you age along the way. If you want to go deeper on any of this, join the Longevity Alliance right here. It's completely free. Okay, that's it for me. I'm out of here. Catch you guys next time.